This is basically just video game stream of consciousness at this point, and I'm going to gradually move some of my video game related topics I've discussed in those videos to here where it's all in one series, but it'll be still be fresh and different and whatever because I'm talking about it later in life, and jokes and opinions evolve on a daily basis. So here's my deal with pre-orders. They shouldn't exist without demos. What happened to demos? They used to be so prevalent. There were entire discs dedicated to them back when that was inconvenient, but we move into the digital age of gaming where they should be easier than ever to distribute and now they're almost nowhere to be found. Pre-ordering is necessary to reserve hard copies of popular games that are going to be sold out instantly at launch otherwise, and it's nice to do digitally too if you want to play a game the night before, like I always do. People want their games right now, and they'll shell out to get it. If there was a game coming out I was really hyped for, I'd pay an extra half price just to get it a month early. Of course, the only way to get games a month early is for free as a journalist by composing an email and promising coverage, which I could technically probably do at this point in my channel growth, but you lost me at compose an email and promise coverage. I'd rather fly a paper airplane through the window of someone's house than draft a cold, unsolicited email to them. That's just uncomfortable to even think about, and duty is the last thing I ever want to be bound by. I wish more developers would just randomly YouTube message me PSN codes for their games, something that has actually happened a couple times. It's always small stuff, and they're very nice and generous about it, but I'm very antisocial and by extension anti-etiquette, so in my head I'm like, don't expect a reply, but also don't expect your code to work for anyone else. I appreciate it, I just wish there was a way for that to come across without me having to say it, you know? But back to demos in relation to pre-orders. You can't expect me to put money down on a game I've yet to try even a sample of. I mean, you can, because we all do, but you shouldn't and we shouldn't. There should be demos available for every game you can pre-order, so you can see if it's worth pre-ordering. I can't believe it ever got to where it's not like that. How was that not the industry standard from the beginning? That's why I respected Final Fantasy XV enough to pre-order it, where I had no experience with Final Fantasy games and had no idea if I'd end up liking it, because it had a demo that did what demos should do, which is exist in a timely manner before a game comes out. Of course, it turned out at launch that FFXV's combat wasn't my style and I didn't grow to accept it the way I thought I might, but I still applaud the demo. Every major game should have one, and indies are available to pre-order all the time too. If your game is big enough for people to want to lock down their purchase of it, you release a fucking demo beforehand and either cement that decision or change their minds. Every pre-order needs some kind of bonus too, something you won't get otherwise to justify my commitment. Not like DLC size, but like a theme or set of avatars would go a long way. By the way, almost every Japanese game on the PSN store launches with 900 avatars that blow up the browsing section, but Danganronpa has none. The Zero Escape franchise has all their main characters, and that's the same company. Where is my Kaede avatar? Fucking Legendary Trail of Cold Steel Heroes, or whatever that game's called, has 7 avatars each for all their 40 characters with different poses and camera angles. That's some unnecessary specificity, but I don't get one Danganronpa V3 Kaede? I'm rioting. I'm sick of my Coco Bandicoot avatar. I've moved on. Help me out here. I don't like episodic games. Not the games themselves, but just the practice of splitting them up into barely morsels of an experience. We wait years for sequels to our favorite games, decades sometimes. You do not need to compound that with months of downtime in between pieces of the same fucking game. You know when you buy the DVD box set of a TV series, and then it dawns on you that you're gonna have to switch out disc after disc after disc after disc after, oh, this one scratched somehow, after disc after disc after now I have back problems? And if you get them digitally, it's still just more separate things taking up space on your dock. Episode 1, episode 2, episode 3, episode I forgot what happened in episode 2, so let me replay that shit real quick. Episode 4. And if you say wait until the full collection is released, well then I have to wait an extra year or so to play portions of a game in sequence. The worst part of television is the waiting. Why would you exacerbate that further in video games? I don't know what the fuck Telltale's trying to pull with Minecraft. It has seasons. If you wanted to give it seasons, you should have just made it a TV show. And I auditioned like 6 months ago to play one of the main villains who I'm not supposed to talk about, and I'm not sure if they've even been introduced in the game yet, but I didn't get it, and I'm bitter because it was perfect for me, and perhaps that's rubbing off on my bias, but I didn't like episodic games before Minecraft either. One of my biggest complaints that I can't believe I didn't remember until now is the fact that games don't consistently depreciate in value. Dude, when Grand Theft Auto 5 isn't on sale, it's still a flat $60, and it came out 4 years ago. This gripe doesn't apply to used games, of course. Except, yes, it does, because a used copy of GTA 5 should be $5 fucking, and I bet it's like 45. And I know why it's still expensive. Obviously, it's popular, people still buy it to this day, but we need some set practices here, because at this point, you are majorly ripping everybody off. Video games are like cars in a lot of ways. Most of them do steadily depreciate as the years go by, becoming less and less expensive as newer models come out, until they reach a point where they stop being old and start being classic, at which time the price skyrockets again for collector's value. That's why a used copy of Super Smash Bros. Melee is $90. That's what I paid in 2017 to buy a GameCube game from 2001, because not only is that game a collector's item, it's still super popular in tournaments and shit, so sellers gouge the fuck out of consumers. Grand Theft Auto 5 is the best-selling game of all time. It already earned that title. What does it have left to prove? Lower your price. It's a four-year-old game that tries to sell you a shark card for $100. Go fuck yourself. Remember when Diablo 3 launched in 2012, and then 5 years later it released a DLC character out of its ass that was a quarter the price of the entire game, and then they thought that in 2017 it makes sense for the complete edition to still be $60 because they're really bad at deciding how much money things should be? Lower the price. It's an old remaster of an even older original product. The Necromancer class is miles away from being worth $15. Go fuck yourself. You'll like this one. Call of Duty Ghosts Digital Hardened Edition. $99.99. To this day. The fifth most recent Call of Duty game seems to think that itself and its season pass are still killing it so hard that you should make it rain dollar bills, 99.99 of them to be exact, on their zombified rotting corpse. And that one didn't even have zombies. Admittedly, I liked Aliens though. Still, lower your price. Activision thinks rust and gold are equally valuable. This game has the online presence of someone in witness protection. Go fuck yourself. There's actually one more, and this one hurts me. Persona 5 Ultimate Edition.
$125. Fuck.
You might say, but wait, Persona 5 doesn't even have a season pass. What could possibly be in the Ultimate Edition to justify such an exorbitant price point? Oh, nothing justifies this shit, let me tell you. As for what's in it, allow me to simplify the list on the store page that is made purposely long and spaced out so you think there's a bunch of worthwhile crap in it. It contains the game, thankfully. It contains healing items and skill cards, costumes, a new difficulty level, Japanese audio, new music, and some personas from earlier entries. All for the low, low price of stand on the nearest ledge and fuck off. Lower your price doesn't cut it. You need to eviscerate it and rethink what your IP is worth. People love Persona, but you can't just pour some superficial nostalgia into a game and double the cost. You guys are maniacs. If I wanted to hear Japanese audio that badly, it would be cheaper for me to buy a second copy of the game in Japanese. This Ultimate Edition is astounding. It takes a bunch of things on the level with common baseline pre-order bonuses and thinks it's worth as much as the game itself. Atlas is a group of monsters, you're scalping your own product, you're also super dumb about YouTube, go fuck yourself. I don't like when people place heightened importance on what difficulty you're playing the game at. I jump around the board with my difficulty. I play Kingdom Hearts 2 on critical every time and love it. I played Persona 5 on normal, then halfway through I switched to easy and had a much more fun time with it. I play Rock Band on expert, cause for rhythm games the hardest difficulty you can do is the only one that's any fun, and I defaulted to the second easiest difficulty in Skyrim. I enjoy the relaxation of easier modes in games that have them, but I don't struggle with Dark Souls or games like it either. It really just depends on the game, but just as I don't shy away from inherently challenging games like Cuphead and Bloodborne, I have no shame whatsoever in taking the easy way out in other games if I feel like it. It's all about your own enjoyment, after all. Well, that's gonna do it for this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. Keep bringing on the comments of what annoys you like usual. They're part of why I've been uploading these so fast, though I'm sure it'll slow down soon. Like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.